What does iodine do for your thyroid anyway? Do you have this question? Welcome. My name is Sarah Peternell. I'm the owner of Family Nutrition Services in Denver, Colorado. I'm also the creator of a 30-day online program called Nourished and Renewed with Hashimoto's. That is a program that answers all of your Hashimoto's questions, way more in depth even than these YouTube videos do. If you have Hashimoto's, especially if you're newly diagnosed, or if you're just experiencing some changes since your diagnosis and you need help, this is the program for you. But today I'm talking about iodine because a lot of people have questions whether or not they should be taking it. Yes, this is very controversial. And I'm going to go into just the finer points today about what iodine does and where you can get it. If you have specific concerns or questions about iodine, you should probably be working with a board-certified holistic nutritionist like me. You can sign up on my website for a free consultation if this would be helpful to you on your journey. I have lots of great packages for people who are interested in joining me in a one-on-one nutrition consultation. This is really important because sometimes with certain supplements, we do need guidance, we do need testing, and we do need personalized information. But as an overview about iodine, today I'm going to tell you that iodine plays a very big role in your body as the backbone or the raw materials for producing thyroid hormones in your body. In fact, we've known for centuries that people who were deficient in iodine had thyroid problems and hence had problems with metabolism and other issues in their body. You may have heard of a goiter. This can also be a condition in which a person has a pretty severe iodine deficiency, and there is swelling and some changes structurally to the thyroid as a result. For most people in the United States, this is becoming more and more rare to develop a goiter. However, it is important to know that if you are not utilizing iodine correctly in your body because of maybe a deficiency or maybe you're having some absorption issues and some digestive issues, you may also be having some issues with your thyroid or conversion of thyroid hormones in your body. So utilizing iodine properly, the thyroid is going to oxidize iodine. That means it adds oxygen molecules to it. And this will help to make T3 and T4, the two most prominent thyroid hormones that are made by the thyroid gland. Basically, without getting into too much of the science, oxidizing means that electrons are removed and oxygen is added. Okay, it's pretty hard to simplify this, but I kind of want you to know that, you know, iodine is important as far as allowing this process to take place. If you don't have adequate amounts of iodine, then your thyroid simply can't properly function. However, having too low of iodine can be almost as problematic as having too much iodine. And this is where some of the controversy comes in. So let's talk about some of the things that maybe are a sign of your iodine deficiency. Well, first of all, as I said, having a goiter is a pretty extreme sign. There are subtle signs about having an iodine deficiency that maybe are not recognized right away. First of all, having weight gain or just weakness in your muscles. That can also be a sign that you're dealing with low iodine. Often we think about B vitamins or maybe even iron as a source of our problems for, you know, a deficiency source for our problems with weakness. But iodine is important as well. Feeling fatigued, having hair issues, skin issues, being chilly all the time, especially on a warm day, feeling changes in your heart rate or maybe issues with like brain fog and memory, or if there's any issues like with your menstrual cycle for the ladies, all of these can be related to low iodine. It's really important if you are pregnant that you are having your thyroid hormones monitored by your medical provider. You want to make sure that your T4 levels are optimal because they're really critical for fetal development. And also you may want to check to see if your iodine levels are sufficient early in pregnancy in case there is a need for supplementation. And you'll make that decision again based with your medical provider. So iodine is very, very important for preventing certain pregnancy complications. There are reasons why we can become deficient in iodine. The first is that we just don't have a lot of iodine in our food supply anymore. Our soils are depleted and our farming practices don't make it really so anymore, unfortunately, that we can get enough iodine from our food alone. We also get food from all over the world. And of course, you know, depending on the footprint of those foods, like maybe your blueberries that came all the way from South America may be degrading in some of their nutritional qualities as time goes on. Second of all, if you don't live near a coastline where iodine is abundantly present in a lot of the seafoods and sea vegetables, right, from the ocean, the closer you get to the middle of your country, the middle of your continent, wherever you live, you just may have less access to foods that are rich in these soils loaded with iodine. The sea, in fact, does give us the best possible sources of our iodine. And in a couple minutes, I'll tell you about sources of iodine in food, and you'll see that there's quite a lot of seafood. Processed foods actually do impact the ways in which we are able to absorb iodine from foods. There are chemicals used in processing called bromide or potassium bromate. Check your labels and see if these are actually on some of the foods that you might be consuming. These are often found in like breads and crackers and some of the refined flour products that are on most grocery store shelves. So what happens is that as these flours are bromated, it's treated with a chemical. It's basically like bleaching it. And what it does is it improves elasticity for baked goods. So bromated basically is kind of a trick that they play on the flours to make it kind of more fluffy, right? But adding potassium bromate or bromide, not only is it a carcinogen all by itself, but it also has the ability to block iodine activity in your body. Some countries around the world have banned the use of bromide in certain types of foods, but it is still used in the United States. So please be aware of this. If you have a thyroid condition, you want to read labels and you want to check to make sure that you're not consuming some of these baked goods, breads, flours, crackers, etc., that contain potassium bromate or bromide. Look for those ingredients on the labels. Another ingredient that is found in our tap water is also among this class of chemicals that can block iodine usage, and this is fluoride. I am not going to go into all of the things that we know about fluoride, but it is important to know that if you're drinking your municipal water right out of the tap, you're probably getting exposed to fluoride. Even using water for showering and bathing and cleaning can also be absorbed through the skin. So please make sure you are aware of what type of water you have in your area. If it's not so good, think about getting maybe a whole house filter or at least a filter on the water that you are drinking so that you can reduce your exposure to internal fluoride and also prevent that blocking of iodine because of fluoride in your system. Maybe I'll do another video about fluoride at another time. Bear with me. All right, there are lots of ways of finding out if you have basically an iodine deficiency. You can read more on my blog at sarahpeternell.com, or you can talk to your doctor about ways to test for iodine deficiency. What I want to finish up today's video with are all of the foods that are rich in iodine. So whether you have a deficiency or not, you could start to incorporate these healthy foods and get the benefits for the support of your total body health as well as the health of your thyroid. All right, are you guys ready for these natural food sources of iodine? Most of these are seafoods. Iodine-rich foods, the most abundant on the planet, are going to be sea vegetables, like seaweed. Have you ever eaten seaweed before? They can actually be quite delicious. So I love to buy strips of like kombu and nori and wakame from the health food store. They're dried, and I use them to cook whole gluten-free grains in my house. So if I'm cooking brown rice, I just take a little strip of kombu, kind of looks like a little piece of tape, and I just stick it in with my cooking liquid, a pinch of sea salt, maybe a little drop of olive oil or something, and the iodine that's present in that seed vegetable, that dried seed vegetable, will actually impart the wonderful properties of iodine right into our brown rice that we're going to have, say, with like a cooked piece of wild caught salmon, or maybe like a vegetable stir fry or something like that. So Actually, it might be easier to get sea vegetables into your diet than you might think, and you don't have to sit down just to chewing on a big seaweed salad. Although I do also love seaweed salad, and I find that it's kind of easy to make. So let's see. Seaweed is the number one thing. Sorry, my computer just closed for a second, so I lost all of my notes. All right, let's get back to my list. Scallops, cod, and shrimp from the sea are all also very rich in iodine. So those are foods that you can incorporate if you don't have any issues with shellfish, like a food allergy to shellfish, you can incorporate those. Foods that are not seafood that you may also incorporate would be yogurt, milk, and eggs. These foods are also rich in iodine. This makes it difficult if you're a vegan to get a lot of iodine outside of just sea vegetables, because if you're eating a balanced diet with, you know, some maybe cultured, raw, you know, fermented yogurt or other dairy products or cheeses, or if you're eating pasture-raised eggs, you're able to get some of those land animal sources of iodine. So it is true that vegans and vegetarians are some of the first people who can become easily iodine deficient if they don't go out of their way either to include sea vegetables or a supplement. This is another reason why working with a holistic nutritionist can be very beneficial, because we can custom or tailor for you a diet plan, a meal plan, recipes, and also supplements that can help to ensure if you choose to follow a vegan or vegetarian diet that you're not becoming deficient, not only in iodine, but many other important minerals and vitamins and as well. I really try to encourage my clients that, you know, supplementation with iodine, because it's tricky and it can be controversial, and there's been plenty of articles and research written about getting too much iodine, that choosing from food is the best option. Yes, it can be, you know, a longer term solution in terms of consuming iodine rich foods versus just going straight to the supplement. But really, from the long term, these changes are going to be much more therapeutic and have much more lasting value. Supplementation with iodine, it has kind of a wide variety of different types of forms, as well as different types of doses, different types of quality levels, depending on where you're buying it from. And personally, if you must supplement, I would recommend that you buy an iodine supplement from your health food store or from your board-certified holistic nutritionist that comes from a food source like kelp or other sea vegetables that have been dried and pulverized and maybe encapsulated, versus going with some of the more synthetic options. Now, this is a personal choice. On my website, you can check out a couple of other resources. In my article on my website, all about iodine in the thyroid, I have a recipe for a soup that is really wonderful, that you can, you know, start to incorporate sea vegetables like wakame into your diet. Also, you can find ways of incorporating more sea vegetables and seafoods as a part of your diet when you check out some of my other online resources on my social media channels. I post a lot of recipes at Instagram. So I have some of those scallop and shrimp recipes there that you can find if you're curious about how to maybe get some more of these foods into your diet. Iodine is a very important mineral for your thyroid. It helps to make your thyroid hormones. If you have Hashimoto's or you have a thyroid condition, generally speaking, getting iodine from foods is a great way to go to provide some more support for this gland. Thank you so much for watching today's video. Be sure to check out other videos that I have about some other important minerals. I also have a video about magnesium, and I also have a video about vitamin D. So check those out. Remember to like, subscribe, and share these videos, and you can turn on your notifications bell so each time I release a new video, you'll be the first to get them. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you soon. Hey there. I am the creator of a 30-day online program called Nourished and Renewed with Hashimoto's. This program is for you if you want to learn how to advocate for your own health and ask the right questions when you're talking to your doctor, and you want to learn all the details about building up your healthy foundation aside from relying solely on medication.
This is a self-paced program, and it's an accumulation of my personal experience from having Hashimoto's and also from 20 or more years working with clients. This program really is the next best thing to working with me one-on-one in my office. In this program, I teach you all about how the thyroid affects your entire body and all of the rest of your hormones. And in this program, Nourished and Renewed, I will help you reclaim your health. You can manage your diet and lifestyle. The link is down below. Check it out. And if you're ready to feel nourished and renewed, this program is for you.